Hi, I'm Janine.
I'm Shannon.
I'm Lewis. Wayne Lewis.
Okay. So, as Niagara College students, we understand that finding something to do for fun, for cheap, isn't an easy task. So, we decided to make a list of the top 10 things to do in the Niagara region for under $20.
Number one.
So, the first place that we thought would be a good place to go to is Dufferin Island. It's free. It's in Niagara Falls. It's like a pond and a nice hiking area. You can go for a nice walk and just hang out on a nice day. In the wintertime, when it freezes over, they put like ice sculptures.
It's a museum in Niagara Falls with some history of Niagara Falls based on Niagara Falls. Do I need to tell you anymore? Like, really?
And it's free on Thursdays from 5 to 9.
Number three, we have Royal Botanical Gardens. Shannon, for whatever reason, can't say botanical, so she says botanical. Makes no sense. But anyways, it's a place in Niagara Falls with a lot of flowers and some gardens, and it's cheap because it's free, and you can have a lot of fun there.
Number
with your lady friend four. We have ghost walks in Noddle. Noddle, for those of you who don't know, is an acronym. Stands for Niagara on the Lake. I'll have Janine. She'll tell you guys what that is, because black people don't go anywhere near ghosts. We don't do that kind of stuff. We always live in the movies, just throwing it out there. Go ahead.
Thanks, man.
No problem.
So the ghost walks in Niagara Lake, they're in the old town. Why can't I not say it? Okay. So in old town, Niagara Lake, you can go in groups of how many you want, or individually, and there's a tour guide that takes you through the city, and then these actors hiding in the city, and they have era-appropriate costumes, and as you walk along the city, they come out and scare you, and as...
Okay, like oh, that, wow. But like, wow. In costume.
Yeah, pretty much. And they're supposed to be the ghosts, so they explain the history of Niagara Lake and all the battles and the wars of 1812 of the lake.
Number five. Number four, because we didn't say the prices.
So adults cost $13, for kids it's $5, and for seniors it's $10.
Number five, Niagara Sky Wheel.
Niagara Sky Wheel is this huge Ferris wheel that's in Clifton Hill, right on the strip. It costs $10.99 for adults and $6.99 for kids.
You get a nice view of the falls and you get to see the entire city. It's really cool.
There's also lights and air conditioning inside these, the little pods. I have been on it, but I still like it.
Me too.
Jesus. Okay, yeah, cool. Okay, moving on now.
Number seven.
Six. Yeah. We have Movielands.
So Movieland is a wax museum that has different movies in it with the characters wax formed. There's also celebrities, and at the end there's a little gift shop. You can get your own hand waxed. For adults it's $10.99, and for kids it's $6.99.
I'm a wax
girl. I think we got it.
Number, okay, seven, for real this time. We have Wizard Golf. You're gonna have to explain it to me. Is this like a Harry Potter type golf thing?
It's like a glow in the dark mini putt.
Harry Potter was a wizard.
It's like a glow in the dark mini putt in Clifton Hill. Adults, it's $9.99. Children, it's $6.99. And apparently for non-golfers, it's $3.99, which makes no sense
whatsoever.
It's probably for people that are going to go, but not mini putt.
But $4, that's a lot of money. I just would stand outside for free.
Number eight is the Horn Blower Cruises. Just drew a blank there. It is the new name for the Maid of the Mist ride. Now, I've never been on it because, again, it involves water and black people can't swim. Adults, it's $19.95 for children, which is how I say children, between the ages of 5 and 12. It's $12.25. I don't really get the 25 part of that, but whatever. And for children under the age of 4 years old, again, and free. Granted, I want to bring my child in if they're under the age of 4 because they can't swim for sure, except for my goddaughter, she can.
Number 9 is the Great Canadian Midway, which is a huge arcade right along Clifton Hill, actually right next to the Movie Land Wax Museum that we talked about earlier. You can spend as much money as you want there, so you can spend under $20 there. There's lots of prizes you can win. There's a little ride in there that we'll talk about for number 10. And there's a Boston Pizza upstairs that you can probably spend under $20 if you buy like a drink, an appetizer. Well, the Ghostbusters ride is a little kind of like roller coaster kind of thing, but it doesn't really, it's not fast or anything. You sit in it and you get this little gun and you get 3D glasses. It's all glow in the dark and with UV lights and whatever you call those. And you have to shoot the little red dots and it knocks the ghost down and you kill the ghost. And by the end, they tally up your score. Whoever has the highest wins.
It's
and
not for even that, realistic.
For that, it is $4.99.
You know what I'm trying to do. $4.99. Well,
need a conclusion.
In conclusion,
thank you for listening to us.
This is Shannon Flamingo.
Hope you
this is Janini Beanie, and I'm Lewis Wayne. Lewis. I see your dirty face hide behind your collar.
Let it rock. something, I'm something. Rolling rock, rubbing rap, running. Miles like it's trying to get a flat stomach. Like Wayne, a personal trainer. My